Hi, Paul Aubin here, and today I'd like to talk to you about key schedules. I've got the advanced sample project open here on screen, and I have a door schedule open. And if we look at this door schedule, we can see that there's lots of fields that are not filled in yet in this schedule. Many of these fields are simple instance-based parameters, which means that if I click into the field, I have to actually type in the value that I want for each of these items, and you'll see that it only affects the door that I have selected. So if I want to input similar values for another door, I'd have to simply type that information in again. So that's going to get fairly tedious. Well, using a key schedule, we can speed up that process quite considerably because we can build a collection of parameters that all go together, and then we can assign them all in a single step. So the frame is a great example of this, where we can define frame types and tell each of those types which material, finish, jam, and head detail they should have. So let's go through the process. I'm going to go to the View tab, click on the Schedule dropdown, and create a new schedule. I want to choose my category of doors. And make sure that you don't choose schedule building components. You want to choose schedule keys. The name of the key can be anything you want. And I'm going to call this frame style. And let's click OK. And you'll see the key name appears over here. So that's going to be frame style. That's going to be the first field in the schedule. And you can add any other fields that you like. Now, the ones I want to add are the ones that we see back here in the background. Frame material, frame finish, jam and head. Click OK. And I'll get a new schedule here that I can begin inputting values to. Now, the way that I do this is to go over here to the Modify tab, and there's a single available button here, New Row. I'll click that. I'm going to click it twice more, and that will create keys 1, 2, and 3. And then you can rename these. So I'm going to have keys A, B, and C. Now I can go about the process of filling in what I want the values for A, B, and C to be. Once I'm done filling all the values, I'm ready to begin assigning these keys to the door objects in my schedule. There's two ways I can do that. I can simply select a door here in the model, come over here to the properties palette, scroll down and find my frame style parameter. That's the key name that I assigned it to earlier, and choose either A, B, or C. When I assign that value, you're going to see all of the other values fill in. Now, that's easy enough to do, but it might be even faster if I build it into the existing door schedule. So what if I come over here to this door schedule, edit its fields, and I'm going to select the frame type field that's already existing. That's this column right here. And in its place, I'm going to add in the frame style. So that'll appear in the same location. I'll take frame type and remove it. And when I click OK, you're now going to see a frame style column replace the previous frame type column. And now I can just simply click there and choose what frame style I want from the list, and all of the other values will fill in. And you can see that I can move very quickly through this schedule, filling in common values, and as an additional benefit, it helps me avoid mistakes and typos because I know that each time I choose a frame style, I'm getting the correct values as assigned in the key schedule. Thanks for watching.